where we left off. So what we were doing before? We were trying to find out on what factors resistance depends on. What are the factors? Material, length, and area. Is there any other factor resistance should depend on? Pressure. If you increase the temperature, what happens? Resistivity increases. So resistance should also increase. Okay. Now the thing is that the resistivity or the resistance, they change very little. Okay. So you can assume that variation to be linear. So there is an assumption here. The variation of resistance or resistivity, they are linear. Just like when you increase the temperature, length changes linearly. L is equal to L naught 1 plus alpha delta T. You remember that?
Yes.
Thermal properties of matter.
Yeah.
Similarly, a similar expression for resistivity is also there. Okay? So write down rho is equal to rho naught 1 plus alpha delta T. This alpha is the temperature coefficient for resistivity. Write down this expression. Resistivity will increase with temperature or decrease with temperature as per expression?
Increase.
So delta T is positive. Resistivity will increase more than rho naught. Fine. Now suppose you increase the temperature by delta T, how resistance will change? Resistance is rho L by A. So it should be equal to what? Rho naught 1 plus alpha T into delta T, then even length will change. L naught 1 plus alpha delta T divided by A naught 1 plus beta delta T. Beta is 2 alpha. This kind of expression you will get. What is? This is temperature coefficient for resistivity. Okay? Any other doubt? Fine. So if you organize this properly, you will get 1 plus alpha T delta T into 1 plus alpha delta T to 1 plus 2 alpha delta T raised to power minus 1. Okay? So if you want to actually find out what happens to resistance, this is what will happen. Okay? You can use binomial approximation and put minus 1 in front. Fine? But then these alphas, they are very less compared to this usually. Okay? So we ignore these. Are you getting it? We ignore change in length and change in area. Fine? So even resistance will follow the similar expression, 1 plus alpha into delta T. Alpha T is temperature coefficient of resistivity or resistance. Both are same. This is an approximation. Any doubt on this? Okay? Fine? Clear? Shall we do a question on it? Once again. Done?
Alpha T
is temperature coefficient of resistivity. You can say linear temperature coefficient of resistivity. Okay? It is usually given in the question. Okay? This is a constant for a material. Alpha T is constant for a material. Alright? You just think like, you know, that linear expansion, radial expansion, similar. Okay? Okay, note down this question. There is an electric toaster that uses nichrome for its heating element. Okay? When negligibly small current passes through it, the resistance at room temperature is 75.3 ohms. Room temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. Okay? And when a toaster is connected to 230 volt supply, This happens at room temperature. But when you connect the toaster with 230 volts, the current settles after few seconds and a steady value of current of 2.68 ampere is observed. Okay? Fine. The temperature coefficient for resistivity is 1.7 to 10 to power minus 4 per degree Celsius. Okay? You need to find temperature in this scenario. What is the temperature of nichrome dioxide? Any doubts on the question? Have you guys understood?
Yeah.
See, at room temperature, this is the resistance. Okay. This is like unknown temperature, whatever is happening here. You need to find that unknown temperature. Temperature coefficient of resistivity is given. Okay. Can you find resistance in this situation? How to find?
V
is equal to IR, Ohm's law.
Yeah.
So how much you get? Resistance should be V by I here. That will be 230 divided by 2.68. This is
85.2.
You actually calculated or used calculator?
I calculated.
Huh?
I calculated.
Right. So 85.2 ohms. Fine. So resistance has changed from 75.3 to 85.2. Okay. And assume that temperature is at this moment is T. The delta T is what? T minus 27. Are you getting it? So the formula for resistance variation with temperature is R is equal to R naught 1 plus alpha delta T. Okay? R is what? 85.2. R naught is 75.3. 1 plus
alpha T minus
T minus 27. Yeah, because this delta T. Now whatever T you get, you will be in degree Celsius. But if you take T minus 100, you will get in Kelvin answer. Okay? When you solve this, you will get around 800 something.
807.
Okay. Are you getting 807? How much?
8000.
No, you are doing calculation error.
Yeah.
Try to solve it your own. These kind of questions, almost everybody know how to solve concept wise. They are testing your calculation only. Everybody knows this expression. You will get T as around 815 or something.
I took a lot of approximations.
So T will be approximately 815 degrees Celsius. No, actually sorry, T minus 27 will be around 815. So T will be 842 degrees Celsius, around this. Okay? So this is how you can find out final temperature. Any doubt on this? Should not be. This is a direct formula substitution, isn't it? Shall we do another question on it?
Yeah.
Okay, since you are welcoming another question, I am giving you another one. Resistance of platinum wire. Write down, resistance of platinum wire at ice point is 5 ohm and resistance at steam point is 5.23 ohms. What is ice point? 0 degrees Celsius. Steam point is 100 degrees Celsius. Okay? So when the thermometer is inserted in a hot bath, the resistance is found to be 5.795 ohm. This is unknown temperature. find out this unknown temperature. The resistance at unknown temperature is 5.795. How much is that unknown temperature? You don't need alpha. Should I do it? Don't use calculator. What?
70 degrees.
Tell me that temperature will be more than 100 or not? Physics is not blind. You can, after getting answer also, you can see whether it makes sense or not. 340?
Yeah,
340.
Around 345.
Around 345. Yeah. Yes, correct. Anybody else got the answer? What? See, formula remains this only. R is equal to R naught 1 plus alpha delta T. What is delta T? Temperature difference between initial and final situation. Now first I will take this as initial and that as final. So R is what? 5.23. It has become this much from 5. This is equal to 1 plus alpha into 100. Delta T is 100 between these two. And between these two, what is delta T? T only. So I can say 5.795 is equal to 5 into 1 plus alpha into T. Okay? I don't want alpha in the expression. So I'll get alpha from here and substitute there. And then you can find the value of T. Any doubt? Okay? So I'll get alpha as 0.795 divided by 5t. This I will substitute here. I'll get the value of t. Okay? Here. Yeah. See, you could have used these two and then these two. Yeah. Then what could have written? 5.795 is equal to 5.23 into 1 plus alpha minus 100 into t. Okay, but I have chosen these two because then you know this expression will be simpler. Yeah. That is the only reason. Your answer will be similar only, may not be same. Okay, yeah, 840. Fine, so we have studied now what affects the resistance. Fine, first we did what affects the resistivity, as in the micro factors that affects the resistivity. Fine, apart from these micro factors, resistance get affected by length and area also. Fine, and then we found out not just that, things get affected by the temperature also. Fine, so our study of the micro factors affecting the resistance or resistivity is over now, but right now we should also learn how to read the resistance. What happens whenever you use resistance in a circuit? Okay, how to write the value of resistance, there is a code for that. It will not be directly written on the resistance that it is 315 ohms. Okay? Because at times resistance are very, very small. Have you seen resistance in the lab?
Yeah.
They have some color code?
Yeah,
violet.
Right? So they have some lines. So there is a code of, you know, colors which you should know how to read. Fine, so that is also there in our syllabus. So let us understand that, how to read the color code and exactly identify what is the value of resistance. Fine, so write down, you should have four columns, okay? A notebook, draw four columns. Write down, this is color. Write down, color. Here, the first color is black. See, first you write down everything, then there is a way of remembering things. You know this already?
No.
Okay, so first write down, then I will tell you how to remember this. Black, brown, red. For the list of colors, write down. Black, brown, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, gray, white, gold, silver, no color. Done? How come? Like I am done, you should be also done.
Covering the board,
sir. Oh, I was covering the board. Now, the way to remember this, see, you should remember this in sequence first. Now, the way to remember this, let's talk about it. first color you should remember, that is black. Okay, so this is BB Roy, BB Roy, Great Britain, has very good wife. And what? Yeah, what is the problem? BB Roy, Great Britain, has very good wife, and what wife wants?
Gold
and silver. And after that, you're not left with any money. No. So see, BB Roy, Great Britain, very good wife, gold, silver, no color. So you can remember this, right? BB Roy, Great Britain, very good wife, gold, silver, no color. Okay? Now, can you write this without, can you imagine this without looking at the notebook?
Yeah.
So, you should remember this in sequence. Okay? So, this is the first column. Shall I proceed? So, the second one is number. Black is associated with 0, brown is 1, red 2, this is 3, 4, 5. So 0 to 9 numbering till white. Okay? Gold and silver are the name. This is multiplier, write down. Multiplier for 0 is 10 to the power 0. This is 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, this is 4, 5, 6, these are the multipliers. There is multiplier for gold and silver also. This is 10 to the power minus 1, this is 10 to the power minus 2. Okay, any doubt? See how logically it flows. First of all, this logic, then you have 0 to 9, and then multiplier. Okay? Now, this is tolerance. Tolerance is nothing but error. Fine? So when you measure this resistance to be of some value, there every measurement has some error. Okay? So the gold is associated with 5% error. This is 10% error. And if there is no color, this is 20% error. Fine? And there is nothing in this. Fine. Okay. Now, when you see a resistance in the lab which has four colors, one, two, sorry, yes, it is like a cylindrical thing, right? From here, one wire comes out, and one wire from there. So it will have four bands of color. Fine. Four bands of colors will be there. The first two bands are first two digits of the resistance. Write down, first two bands are first two digits of the color. Okay? The third band is a multiplier. Is a multiplier. So like first two digits are 2 and 2, it becomes 22. Third multiplier is 10 to the power 4. So 22 into 10 to the power 4. Okay? First two colors are the first two digits. Okay? Then multiplier is, you have to multiply those two digits with that multiplier. Now when you say multiplier, you have to pick from here. And first two digits of the colors you should pick from here. You are asking something?
Yeah, so like when you hold a resistor or something, which side you get your...
Oh, you will see the tolerance, right? So tolerance should come at the end.
At the bottom. So
yeah.
The colors.
Yeah.
So the gold, silver, and no color.
Yeah. Okay.
Now what if there's no color?
Then there will be, you know, there will be space left out like this. So these three colors will be closer to this side. Okay. So you'll be able to make out. So there is a fourth color, that is tolerance. Fine. That is tolerance. So tolerance, how it is written? Plus minus 5%. Plus minus 20%. Fine. So let us see whether you guys can find out what is the resistance of this. This is suppose yellow. Don't talk. This is brown. This is green. This is silver. Tell me what is the resistance of this?
41 × 10⁻¹⁵
All of you?
Yeah.
So yellow is what?
Yellow is 4.
Yellow is 4 and then what? Brown. Brown is 1. So 41, first two digits. And then you have green. Green is multiplier. So that is 10⁻⁵. So 41 × 10⁵. Because this third color. Okay? Plus minus silver, which is 10%. So plus minus 10%. Fourth color is tolerance. Okay, let us try this also. Tell me what is the value of resistance here?
40.
Yellow is what? 4. Black is 0. So 40 × 10⁻¹ plus minus 10%. Is it clear now? Okay. So you can actually see this thing in lab and try to read the resistance. Good time pass, huh? And do that.